guys, hope you're all having a wonderful week so far. I decided to film a chatty get ready with me style video because it's been so long since I've done one and I love filming these. They're just really like low key and chilled. So hope you guys enjoy this video and let's get started. Everyone is currently obsessed with the Huda Beauty Faux Filter Foundation, and while I do think it's a nice foundation, I'm not like obsessed with it as much as everyone else is, so I'm still not sure if I'm missing something. So I'm gonna try it again today and mix it in with some Marc Jacobs Do You drops. Yeah, so I've been thinking a lot about how we feel about things in the moment versus how we feel about them when we look back on them. Most of us would have gone through periods of our lives that were totally normal. Nothing significant happened, it wasn't necessarily exciting or nothing standout occurred, but when you look back on it, it seems a lot better than it was in that moment. And I'm trying to think back to when Reese and I, it was around the time that Reese and I started dating. And we lived in this apartment by the beach, and it was just like in that moment, I took it for granted. Like I was just, it was kind of, I came from Bondi being by the beach, so I definitely took it for granted. But now that I look back, and we were so quick to want to get out of that place, like we were like, oh, let's buy a house, and it was so exciting, the whole process of looking for houses and, you know, do we build, do we do this, do we do that? Then we found a house and that was great, and you know, I love this house, it's a beautiful house, but when I look back on when we lived in that apartment, I remember it like it was the best time of my life or something like that. And it doesn't have anything to do with, you know, meeting Reese around that time, because our relationship's better now than it was back then. But I don't know, I think it's because I miss being by the beach is the main thing, but there are so many other times in my life where I look back now and I'm like, gosh, was it really that amazing, or am I just only remembering the good parts? Because in that moment, I didn't feel like my life was, you know, the best it's ever been or anything like that. Does anyone else ever have that? It's not all the time, it's just sometimes, but I'm trying to stay in the moment as much as possible because that's all we have is the present moment. This foundation's definitely not the right color. It's too light. So I've been working on a new venture. Like I was working on this big venture a couple of years ago. And I told all my close friends and family about it, and every single time I'd see them, they'd ask me about it. And that was fine for a while because it was still going ahead. But when it came to a halt for many reasons, and it was for the best, everyone was still asking me and I was like, it's not happening. And then I felt like I was letting them down. And so anyway, this new venture, literally told no one. My friends are all killing me, like asking me, tell me, like, when can you tell me? And I'm just saying, when I'm ready. And Reese and I are actually working on it. No one else is involved. We thought about getting investors on board, but we had come so far on our own and I was like, it's scary, but let's actually try and do this ourselves. So no external funding. It's just our little passion project, or my little passion project, more so than Reese's. You'll understand why when I launch. But I'm just really, really, really excited about this. It's something that I've wanted to do or thought about doing for ages, but I just never took it seriously. So it's been about a year and a half probably in the making, and we'll probably reveal it to everyone in like February or March. And so excited. It's like, yeah, I should have done something, like released something a long time ago. Like I'm really, really late in doing this, but I don't feel like back then was the right time to do it. I feel like now is the right time. As you guys know, I always harp on about it. Everything happens for a reason, and I feel like I'm always on the right path and everything's always happening how it's meant to. And that gives me a little bit of peace of mind. Not that I really need it, but just so I stop being in my head so much, as I always am. It's just really exciting and I hope you guys like it. I applied it all with a brush and then I dabbed it on my finger and then used this beauty sponge to blend it out, and it actually looks stunning like this. Like really, really nice. I just wish the color was right. It had ghosty eye look. I feel like 2018 is going to be one of the best, if not the best year in a long time. I don't know what it is. I feel like 2017 was fine. It was a year of changes. But it was fine. Like I'm fine. Nothing really bad happened. It wasn't necessarily a really exciting year. It was just a year. But 2018, I feel like it's going to bring a lot with it. And I'm very optimistic. And excited to see what it has in store for us. I was thinking about it today. I have literally changed my makeup style completely. I used to be so full coverage, 24/7, always fake tanned. And I still love being full coverage, fake tanned. I wear foundation probably like maybe once a week. Maybe once a week. And that is shocking for me. Like, shocking. Now that I've got my brows tattooed, which is the best thing I've done in a long time as well, I put like one or two strokes in them and I'm done. I've actually been wearing mascara a little bit less as well, which is a big deal for me. When I don't wear mascara, my face looks so different, but I've never been more confident with myself in my natural state as I have been in, since I was, like, before YouTube probably. And so when I do wear foundation, I tend to be a lot more critical of it because it looks more cakey and accentuates my fine lines and stuff, because you can't see those normally when you don't have foundation on. And so recently I've actually been leaving my foundation and not powdering it, which is even more insane for me. Like, not wearing foundation, okay, whatever, but not powdering my foundation. I mean, I still powder like a T-zone, but everywhere else, that's crazy for me. Okay, so for this highlighter technique, I take the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Dim Light. So a lot of people who like a really dewy finish can set their face with this. And it doesn't completely mattify it. It just adds a really subtle kind of glowy sheen. So I'm going to use that on a Morphe M509 brush. This is my favorite highlighting brush. And I'm just going to dust that in the C shape, just really lightly over my cheekbones. One thing I don't like about this is that it does actually add some color to my face. It kind of almost bronzes my face a little bit, but it helps just kind of blur out the edges a little bit before I apply my actual highlighter. So I used the Mecca Cosmetica Enlightened Powder, which is this, ooh, how shiny that is, on the same brush. And this one is, as you can see, really intense. And then I just blend that on and it just makes my whole face look glowy. Next product is the Hourglass Ambient Strobe Lighting Brilliant Nude Blush. This is another one that I love if I want to have a really dewy finish. I mean, artificially dewy, of course. But we all know how easy it is to get sucked into social media and, you know, likes and comments and attention and numbers and this and that. And it's so exhausting, especially if that is your business. Obviously, if you're an influencer, then that is one of the ways you make money. So kind of got to think of it from a business perspective. Just to interrupt myself, I'm going to use the Benefica Brow Pomade to fill in my brows. I've been loving this for my brows recently when I've been wanting a bit more definition. So yeah, it's easy for it to become overwhelming and easy to compare yourself with everyone else and to think that, you know, Instagram is reality. It can just so easily consume your life. And so recently I've been thinking of it as like a game, something that we're all playing, something that we all enjoy, but not something to get confused. Ooh, ow. Not something to get confused with reality, because it's not. It's a part of your reality because it's your doing that. You're, you know, spending your time doing that. So it's part of your reality, but it is not reality itself. And, you know, it's like people trying to get high scores and points, which is like likes and lots of followers and this and that. Everyone's just trying to, yeah, I guess get a high score, which sounds really weird. But when you actually think about it, it's very accurate. Some people spend their whole lives dedicated to it and playing it. And other people don't really have an interest in it. They'll play it every once in a while. And don't get me wrong, like a lot of it, my Instagram posts, well, my Instagram in particular is very personal. I mean, I'm not like an Instagram powerhouse that puts out like a million really high quality photos every day. Like, I do my best, but I'm not like, it's not my life because of this way I think about it now, and that I know that it's not reality and that my reality is my family, my boyfriend, my friends, my dog, like things that make me happy in real life. And Instagram doesn't really do that for me. Like, I like looking at it. I like seeing what my friends are up to or people that I follow are up to, but I don't place too much importance on it. Like, I don't get it confused with what's really important. So when I do a post, or, you know, I'll check my comments and I'll reply and I'll do this and I'll do that, but I just don't take it too seriously. Like, I know that there's so much more out there that's so much more important. It's just so easy to forget sometimes that what we see online is constructed and it's the best part of everybody's life. Does anyone else think like that? Does anyone else have that same kind of viewpoint? I'm also really grateful to have, like, as awesome as it would be to have an Instagram husband and to have someone who could be that person. I mean, it would be so handy and so convenient, but I am just so glad that Reese isn't into social media. I'm so in my head about it to my, you know, detriment that it's exhausting. And if he was also the same way or also cared about it, then I think it would just, I'd go insane because it's so hard to find that perfect balance. And having someone who doesn't go on it kind of restores that balance for me. It's just nice having someone who doesn't care about it, because it helps me not to care about it and it helps me to stay in the moment. And I know I harp on about this stuff a bit sometimes, but a lot of the time it is just to remind you guys, especially my younger followers, that Instagram is not real. It's just a game. A game that people play, and that's it. I know I've been talking about like deep stuff in this little chat, but that's the real stuff. I'm just keeping it real. I don't know. I just like talking about real stuff. Stuff that actually affects all of us. I'm going to use this BH Cosmetics Zodiac palette. Ooh yeah, those are the shades. I'm going to use this shade, then that shade, and a Scorpio on the lid maybe. Again, this is not a tutorial, so I'm allowed to do a look that I always do, okay? Before anyone comes at me with those comments. Ooh, nice. Do you guys like advice videos? Or just like, you know, question and answer videos where you're talking about real issues, not just YouTube related stuff? Because I love those videos. I was watching one of my old ones back a couple of hours ago and just reminded me, like, I've got to do more of those. But then I don't know if people really watch them anymore. YouTube has changed so much since I filmed those that I don't really know if there's a place for them anymore. But my mantra has now become to release content that I actually want to release, not what I think I should or what will get the most views. Because at the end of the day, the people that follow me and love what I do will watch it regardless. And the people that don't won't. And that's fine because that's just the way it is. So I've just got to stop caring. And I have been actually really good. I've been releasing videos that I know won't attract as much attention, but you know, I'm happy with them and that's all that matters really, because I'd feel worse if I started doing videos that got lots of views that I didn't actually, that I couldn't stand behind. So I feel like it's the better way to go. These eyeshadows are gorgeous. What is one of your life goals? One of my biggest life goals is to have a house on the beach. That's just something that I've, like, to actually own one, not just to rent one, to own my dream house on the beach. One of my other main goals in life that isn't as materialistic as having a nice house is to earn enough money that I can pay off my parents' mortgage, buy them a nice house, a nice car. Well, not even a nice car, like, it doesn't matter, just give them financial freedom type thing. I don't come from money, if you didn't already know that. I'm sure if you are watching this video, you probably already know that, but I don't come from money, so I know the value of it and I know how much it would, I mean, how much does money help any family, but to be able to do that for my family would just mean the world to me, so I would absolutely love to be able to do that. I also, one of my life goals is to, and Reese doesn't feel the same way about this one, so that's a very big issue in our relationship. I'm kidding. But I want to have a huge block in the country, like a beautiful block of land with lots of rescue animals, and just like retire on that farm with my rescue animals and have enough money behind me that I can take care of them and bring in new animals and rehome the old ones, or just let them live out their last days there. My dad used to live in the country, so I spent a lot of my time when I was growing up in the country, and I just love it. It's so peaceful and tranquil, and we had the little farm animals. Oh, such good memories. So I would love to be able to do that. But Reese doesn't really want to do that because it doesn't appeal to him as much as it does me. But that's like retirement. That's not like right now. Oh, wow. Are you kidding me? Holy, what? That's a good question, actually. My star sign is Capricorn. And I want to know, I've got friends that are so into horoscopes. And I'd love to be, like, I just haven't really put much time into, like, you know, learning more about it. But do you guys believe in horoscopes? And you know, some people like swear by them and always say, oh, Mercury's in retrograde and all that stuff, which I have no idea what that even means. But then when my friends who are really into it tell me stories about people or tell me like what traits certain horoscopes have, I'm like, damn, that's actually true. And all the horoscope things that I read about me being a Capricorn and Reese being a Virgo have all been spot on, like just our traits and how compatible we are and stuff like that. So I don't know. Part of me is like, oh, I don't know. The other half is, you know what? Maybe there's some truth to this. Those eyeshadows were stunning. Next, I want to try these Huda Beauty Faux Mink lashes. They look like this. These lashes are so long that on this bit here, when I look up or straight across, they're actually like curled, like bent. They're crooked. I don't know if you can see. We can't see. Anyway, these lashes are a whole lot more intense than I thought they'd be. They're really nice though. They're just very intense. But I think I'm going to try this Lawless liquid lipstick in Leo. This shade. I loved the other one that I tried in the shade Cameron, I think. Ooh, these are such nice lip products. That is the finished makeup look. I love the eyes are so bronzy and definitely right up my alley. The skin is beautiful. The foundation looks really, really nice. I think it is better when I apply it that way, so with a brush than with a beauty blender. Lips are amazing. I love the dewy skin. I mean, it's not even a makeup look, so I'm not sure why I'm like showcasing the look now, but anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this like chit chat style video. Let me know what you thought. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye.